Diplomatic Center in the Collector's Office mandate. He has worked for more than 12 years in various sectors. Mr. Rajesh Bhusani.
Certificate. If you want to have caste certificate, what you will do? So, my presentation is on Setu Nanded. Basically, this is, I am going to present a success story of Information and Facilitation Center, which we have set up in November 2001. And yesterday we have seen a lot of hot discussions over CICs, CSCs, but for them, they can look at this project because it was started way back, 6 years back, and it is running successfully. And more important is that it is self-sustained. This is more important for today's conference, that this project is now self-sustained and we have gathered a good wealth for the public and the community. So let us start with the Setu Nanded. Setu Nanded, it is operated by Setu Samiti, a unique center in state of Maharashtra, self-dependent in a short period. You might be seeing two logos, one on right hand, one on left hand. Initially, when we were started, there was no policy regarding setup of Information Facilitation Center. So we have designed our own logo with name E-Suvidha. Later, in 2002, Government of Maharashtra has declared official policy to start such centers across the district place and tehsil place, and they have issued a new brand or logo for that, and with a new name that is called as Setu. You might be seeing few words below that is Sevetun Samadhan, that is the service, satisfaction through service. So let me explain you what is Setu. Setu is an information and facilitation center that is located in the premises of Collector Office Nanded, and it is an attempt to provide better services. It is not that Collector Office is not providing any services to the applicants or its citizens, but this was a better attempt to provide the same services in a new fashion with use of ICT. Setu, as I told you, Setu is a Marathi word, and it means that it is a bridge. So Setu is a bridge between common person and the district administration. Nanded is the district name. Nanded was early mover for such project. We started in November 2001, and the government of Maharashtra has declared. Okay. And government of Maharashtra has declared official policy to start such centers in 23rd of August 2002. This is the inauguration slide. The center was inaugurated by Honorable Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Vilasrao Deshmukh, on November 4th. So let me explain the highlights of the Setu. In Setu, we get prompt settlements of all routine matters of the citizens, empowering citizens through easy dissemination of information, reducing frequent visits of applicants to government offices. You might have experienced about such. When you want a certificate, license or permit from government office, often you have to visit, many times you have to see the babus, many times you have to meet the officers to get your work done. So this has reduced the frequent visits of applicants to government offices, increase the confidence of citizens towards the district administration, valuable human resource for more productive work. This is a more important thing. Before starting the Setu Center, all the babus or clerks, all the officers, they are engaged in doing the same and same repeated work, and they couldn't find time for other works. They were overloaded, but with these centers, the valuable human resource we could save, and that time can be allotted for other works. The plan and objective for this Setu Center is, under one roof, different works, efficiency and transparency in administration, public-oriented district administration, this is now buzzword in government, save money and time of common people. Highlights: we accept 64 types of applications from the citizens. From the 6 offices, they are Collector Office, SDM, Tehsil, Taluka Inspector of Land Records, BDO, which is a part of rural development, and RTO. Then, apart from this, we have separate counters to issue property card. Property card is an important document for the citizens staying in urban area, whereas for the rural areas, it is Satbara or Record of Right. Then we generate computerized affidavits with photographs, acceptance of grievance, complaints, facilitating citizens each day as Lok Shahidin. Government of Maharashtra has started one program that is called as Lokshahi Din. It is conducted on every first Monday. Any citizen who is having some grievance can come to collectorate and it is solved immediately. But now we have not restricted it up to the Monday only. Every day any citizen can come and launch his grievance. And then the communication center equipped with internet, email, SD, you might go through it. Executive magistrate for coordination and certification of computerized affidavit. This is a very important point. Suppose if you want to make an affidavit, you have to go to court and you have to find one notary, you have to pay him some money, then he will certify your document. There is no need in the center. In the centers, we have appointed one Tahsildar, he is a rank of executive magistrate, who does it on a free of cost. Then we have established one bank counter of SBS, government of RBI has given permission for that, to accept only government transactions. Then man rattled this for literature season, sale of bonds, stamps, prescribed forms. One can get blank application forms, one can get stamps, one can get prescribed proformas, formats, etc. Computer-based inquiries counter. Major certificates like nationality, domicile, income, likewise 64 certificates are issued from this center. And for RTO, it is, you can get a duplicate license, you can get your license renewed, and you can get learner's license. Learner's license you can get on one day only, because the officials have the right to travel from his office to our service center. The issuance of property card and record of right. Let me explain you about the record of right. It is Satbara. It is the most important document for a farmer. And Nanded is the only one district in Maharashtra where we have banned manual Satbara, manual arrowar. We issue only computerized arrowar. The whole data entry has been done. Until now, we have issued more than 8.5 lakhs of arrowar. The local area networking covering Setu, collector office, Tahsil. We have networked all these offices. Then what is the functional role? How it was set up? It was set up at low cost. Initially, with the help of NGO, the project expenses were met out for the center. In 2001, one picture was released, Lagan. We have taken one charity show of Lagan. Through that, we have collected money about 1.5 lakhs, through which we could meet out the expenses for furniture and other things in the center. Then software and technical support was given by NIC for my department. At no cost, we have developed a single window system for the center. Then authentication of documents by competent authority. They were posted from the government of Maharashtra. What is a credible job for the center? It is an excellent example for design and development. Expenses were meeting out in a joint venture and funds raised from the citizens of Nanded. In fact, we said that it is the most cost economic solution in the field of e-governance. Because generally we have seen that in e-governance, the technology is dominant. But here, technology and administration, they go hand in hand. 10 plus youths got job as operator when program manager and manager are deployed for the Setu project in the center. Now, what are the features of this center? Fully computerized, 10 computers, 2 servers, 1 server is standby server, 4 printers, 3 web camera, UPS, 10 plus operators, involvement of 6 offices. This is the important thing. And 64 types of certificates and proofs, 23 different photo-based computerized affidavits. Another important slide I would like to explain. The construction is at no cost. There was a building in our premises which was about to dismantle, and the dismantle certificate was given by PWD, but we asked them rather to, instead of dismantling the building, you renovate it for our Setu center, which they did at no cost. Then furniture, local NGO, just I told you. Then computers were brought from the local area, local MLAs and MLC funds. Software was provided by NIC. So after that, we have adopted quality management system for this center. See, what we thought, the center should not be a person oriented, it should be a policy oriented. So we have opted for quality management system. And in 2004, we got ISO certificate for this center. This is the only center in Maharashtra which got an ISO certification. Then in 2006, we got nominated as a finalist in Stockholm Challenge Award in the public administration category. We got an award in Rajiv Gandhi Pragati Abhiyan. So this is the statistics. Till when the center started in November 2001 up to 2007, more than 1.14 lakhs customers, they appeared in the center and they got certificates. I have given the total total admission received, total distribution, total rejected, rejection percentage, total admission delay, and delay percentage. You might be seeing that NA in the first column, because that was at that time no quality management system or no measurement system was devised. When we opted for the ISO, then we got a system to measure everything, so we got some results. So that was a delay in 2003-2004 when we started the ISO certification, which was gradually released, reduced. Then the rejected percentage, you might be seeing that in 2003-2004 it was around 1.4, then it was reduced, again it was increased last year, because government has changed guidelines to issue the CAS certificate. So all the CAS certificates which were accepted in the center were blindly rejected. Then the important is the SETU financials. As you know, I told that the center was started at no cost. But now, in 5 years, we have created a wealth of 41 lakhs rupees to the service charges. The service charge is very nominal. It is 10 rupees per customer and per service. So what were the hurdles to start the center? Elimination of middlemen for getting work done in 6 offices. There was malpractice corruption in issuing certificate licenses from our own office. Then reluctant staff, there was no allocation of funds from the government, and resistance to adopt new IT culture, less willingness in execution of the responsibility. All they were related, partly related with the government officers and partly from the other side. How we have overcome? We have motivated the staff, then pre-implementation planning, administrative skills to improve the interest, efforts to change mindset with the new trends of e-governance. Then, of course, we have provided a strong technical support to all the staff working in the center as well as back end. Sufficient in-office training, reducing involvement of middlemen, towers and agents. Citizen did not appear to the table of Babu, so obviously check for corruption. So he did not contact to any person, official person. He has just to ask, he has to inquire about his certificate in the center only. We have an inquiry counter where he can inquire, and he did not meet anyone. Then what is the impact of this SETU before 2001 and now? We are divided in 3 parts: within organization, outside organization, and socio-economic impact. Within organization, the project has improved the government working culture in the office, and it has brought discipline. This is very important. Automation in files status monitoring has brought self-discipline in the working staff, increase in the efficiency of government staff. I told that they can save time now, they can utilize this time for other works. The crowd has diverted to the SETU, results in increase of concentration the staff working in the government. Reduction in the time delay or pending cases. Outside, everyone knows the center has facilitated the submission of applicants in one location. There is prompt service and assured within the time limits. We give them acknowledgement receipt when they file their application, that on so and so date you come and you take your certificate. Cost effectiveness and time saving. The common man did not visit the officers or working staff or to know his status of pending cases. Increase interest of common man towards government. This is more important. The center has created job opportunities for the job aspirants. The project has brought transparency and time-saving solutions for a common man. Implementation of Right to Information Act. We have installed one kiosk where a common man can come and see the status of his file at any time. Then we have developed a fully featured website where the project information, selective downloads of blank application forms, how to apply for the certificate, licenses, permit, everything has been given on this website. Then the current scenario, with the one center, now we have started 15 centers in every tahsil place on boot basis, as built, own, operate and transfer. We means government has not invested a single money, single paisa in these centers. All they are starting, how they have started on boot basis, and they are running well. More than 5 lakhs applicants satisfied throughout the district. Now SETU Samiti, it is a society, it is registered under 1816 Act. They are holding a deposit of 41 lakhs in nationalized bank within 5 years. Web-based application is under development for online filing. It is proposed one. So thank you very much. I think I'm finished in time.
Thank you. Call it e-all or VIC. For those of you who may know a little bit of Kannada literature, I'm reminded of a famous piece about 2000 years back, a poet described Karnataka as saying, Puritodadayum Kavya Prayoga Parinadamatigal. He meant without doing a BA or MA in literature, the people in Karnataka were able to create wonderful literature. I think EBIC, which is being tried in Karnataka, will make us Puritodadayum Computer Prayoga Parinadamatigal without an MCA or BTech or anything. I'm sure the whole, all the lower level, I mean districts and taluks can use very meaningfully, purposefully the computers. The next presentation by Dr. Prabhat Ranjan, he said he will take us from humans to the animals, but I'm sure once he perfects there, it will come back to the animals, what with increasing wildlife of terrorists, IT evaders, psychopaths, rowdies, the B group, the A group, and so on. So hopefully the technology will again be useful here for government to track them. Rajesh Bhusari made a very interesting presentation on a successful implementation. He calls it good governance. Let us hope e-governance will start standing for enjoyable governance. I would like to thank all the speakers and all the participants for letting us have a wonderful session. Thank you very much.